Good afternoon. Welcome to the Transition Center graduation. We're so happy that you're here. Before we begin, would you take a moment and check your cell phones and make sure that they're turned to a silent or a mute mode, please? Today, we're here to celebrate the final stages in the educational career of these young people that you see sitting here. We're so excited to have you here. We thank the parents and families and guests that are here who have helped these students on their journey to this day. I'd like to introduce Dr. David Benson. Dr. Benson is going to start our program with some remarks.
Thank you. Well, good afternoon, everybody. On behalf of the Board of Education and the faculty and staff of the entire school district, I want to welcome you and extend congratulations to our honored graduates who are finishing their educational experience here with us and taking that next step. The next three evenings, we have high school graduations, and last night in this very room, we had the Metro High School graduation. So this is truly one of my favorite times of year as I get to see all of these fine young men and women come forth and receive the recognition that they have earned and certainly deserve. It is one of the great moments for me as an educator to be able to experience this opportunity. You know, I'm just going to make brief comments. In my 42-year career as an educator, I've seen a lot of change in this business as we have gone from a non-digital age to a digital age where we have information about students and about their work that literally we swim in data sometimes, but it's hard to make meaning of it sometimes. But I want you to know that this is first and foremost a relationship business. And the relationships that we have built with these fine graduates and the others in this community will stand the test of time. Our transition staff is an outstanding group of individuals, and they truly care about all of the students and have provided them additional guidance and help along their educational path to get to this point. In this country, we love and cherish all children. That was memorialized into federal education policy in 1975. It took a long, long, long time in this country to get to that point. And that was during my career, and I do remember being a young teacher when we were first introduced to the Individuals with Disabilities Act, IDEA, and IDEA told us as educators that it was our responsibility. And I think IDEA has played a great role in several issues. First, it told us that we are responsible for all children. That is an important step forward in the social dynamics of this country, and all children now receive educational services at their local school district and have extended service opportunities if it's appropriate. Secondly, it required us to educate a group of professionals that had certain skills and abilities and work habits and ethics and moral compasses to work with all children. Those educators have, in fact, educated the rest of us around issues that are important. Third, those issues have increased the pedagogical skills, the teaching skills, of all of our faculty and staff. And that has been a great outcome as we have learned how to work with everyone. And finally, it brings us to today, where we have the opportunity to celebrate these fine young men and women, to congratulate them, and to wish them well on their future and in their future endeavors. On behalf of the board, I want to congratulate the graduates and to welcome you here to our facilities and to extend our thanks for all of your support over the years, not only for your individual children, but for education in general. Thank you.
Thank you, Dr. Benson. I really appreciate you bringing up IDEA and the support for all kids, and I know the people in this room do too. Next, our Executive Director of Special Services, Mrs. Sheila Lehman, has some comments.
I'm very happy to be able to be here today. I'd like to take a few minutes today to recognize Cindy Donaldson. Cindy is retiring at the end of this year after 10 years of service to the district, which included direct support of all things associated with our transition center. Cindy is a tireless advocate and champion for our very special students. She lives and breathes the concept that a measure of society is how it cares for its most vulnerable citizens. Cindy is that caring force. Cindy started when the Transition Center was at the Roosevelt Hotel. Well, then the flood came, and she helped us navigate through those very muddy waters, including finding a temporary home for the Transition Center in our FEMA trailers, and then finally landing in our current location on 3rd Avenue. We are so fortunate that our predecessors had a vision for a transition center for our older students. But it is Cindy's efforts, and those of all the staff as well, that has made our transition center a thriving and successful program. And we thank all of you for that. We salute you, Cindy, for your years of dedication. We will not forget all that you have done for the Transition Center and how you have shaped it to what it is today. Your spirit and energy will always be felt and will guide us to move forward. We wish you all the best, Cindy. Enjoy the adventure that awaits you.
Okay, I kind of knew this was coming, but not until yesterday when I finally looked at the program. So thank you, Sheila. Those words mean a lot to me, too. I just want to add that when I was offered my job 10 years ago, I was told that one of my responsibilities was to support the Transition Center at the Roosevelt Hotel. And for a moment, I had a moment of crisis because although I had raised two teenagers of my own, I wasn't sure I was going to take on 20-some 18 to 21-year-olds living in a hotel. And Suzanne Blumey, who was the executive director at that time, quickly assured me that although the program was housed at the Transition Center, the students were not. So whoosh, a sigh of relief. Sheila went through some of the things that have happened at the Transition Center in the last 10 years. And I guess I can say that it embodies what we've been through, transitions. And so all of us, whether we're students or adults, have to go through transition, and we certainly have. This is a phenomenal staff. They will continue to do great work. And I just appreciate the time that I had with them, and I guess I'm proud to say I was one of us. So thank you very much. Okay, I forgot to introduce the staff in my hurry to get Dr. Benson to the stage. So would the Transition Center staff please stand and be recognized. Thank you. And Lori, would you stand for a moment? Lori Allen is also transitioning along with me, and Lori has decided to move on to the next chapter of her life, and so she'll be retiring too. Lori has been with the Transition Center since it began, so thank you, Lori. Okay, graduates, are we ready? Okay. Our first graduate is Douglas Boyd. Doug started his school career at Grant Elementary. From there, he enrolled at Kenwood to complete his primary grades. Ready for middle school, Doug attended Harding Middle School. After surviving those middle school years, it was on to Kennedy to become a loyal Cougar. Doug has been at the Transition Center for the past 2 years. Doug has experienced many of our work sites during his time at the Transition Center. He's worked as part of a supervised crew and independently in the community. The Clarion Hotel needed an experienced cleaner. Doug fit the bill. At times, we have needed a person to fill in at Grantwood AEA. Duties there include packaging science materials. Doug filled in nicely. At Quiznos, he completed a variety of tasks, such as dishes and restocking supplies. After spending time at these work sites under the supervision of staff, it was time to take the next step and have Doug try working independently in the community. St. Luke's Hospital needed a person to manage the inventory of office supplies. Doug really liked his job because he got a free lunch each day. While at St. Luke's, he also worked in the laundry area preparing surgical gowns. Keystone Place Retirement Community was looking for an individual to work in the dish room. The staff talked with Doug, and a partnership was formed with Keystone. This past spring, the Meals on Wheels program needed a person to clean coolers after the meals were delivered. Again, a connection was made, and Doug filled the position. Doug has always been a participant in Special Olympics. During his time at the Transition Center, softball throw and bowling were his specialties. In his free time, Doug is an avid Boy Scout. He's a troop leader and very close to receiving his Eagle Scout Award. Congratulations, Doug. That was the first congratulations. He also enjoys crocheting. He even made Lindsay a hat. Just don't call it knitting. In his free time, Doug is an avid boy. Oops, sorry, read that already. After graduation, Doug is exploring a couple of options. He visited Job Corps in Ottumwa. He also had the opportunity to go to Goodwill for a work evaluation. I think Doug is going to choose Goodwill. Doug, we hope you enjoyed your time at the Transition Center. We have enjoyed having you with us. Good luck in the future. You are a hard worker with some good skills. Success is right around the corner. Congratulations, Doug. Just do a little arranging. Our next graduate is Adam Burgess. Adam began his school career attending the Grant Early Childhood Program. From there, Adam enrolled at Coolidge Elementary to complete his primary grades. The next stop for Adam was Roosevelt to complete middle school. Ready for high school, Adam donned the blue and white of Jefferson High School. Adam has been a student at the Transition Center for the past 3 years. You won't find a student who brings more enthusiasm to our work sites. During Adam's tenure at the Transition Center, he's worked at nearly all of our supervised crew sites. If you've ever stayed at the Clarion Hotel, chances are Adam cleaned the room you left. Quiznos needed a person to bus tables over the lunch hour. Adam was the man for the job. At the Salvation Army, DJ needed help with cleanup after serving lunches to the needy. Adam again filled that need. Benchmark is a roof consulting firm that needs help with their recycling program and filling the copying machines. Benchmark is an office with lots of cubicles, so it's easy to get lost. Adam never got lost. We can't say that for some of the staff. Adam also worked independently in the community. At Gringo's, he shredded cheese and wrapped silverware. The ladies really liked him there. At St. Luke's, Adam worked in the laundry area, folding towels and packaging isolation gowns in bags of 25. Last winter, he also completed a Goodwill work evaluation. The intent of the work evaluation was to assess work skills and habits. He really liked this experience because he was paid. Adam has always participated in Special Olympics. He's very competitive and loves the thrill of victory, but not so much the agony of defeat. At the Transition Center, he's participated in bowling and track and field. When Adam has some free time, you can usually find him surfing the internet for the latest pro sports scores. He often attends Colonels or Rough Riders games. Adam also has an interest in muscle cars. After graduation, Adam will continue living in his group home. He has a position waiting for him at Goodwill Industries. He also will attend the ARC Dayhab program a few days a week. Adam, the 3 years have gone by so fast. The energy and enthusiasm you bring to the program will be missed. Good luck and stay in touch. Congratulations. While Adam's walking back to his seat, I wanted to mention that if you listen to these speeches, you will hear a total of 15 community employers who have provided experiences for our students. And so I think that's a wonderful recognition for the Transition Center and the partnerships, and it's also a wonderful recognition for members of our community. Our next graduate is April Dixon. April began her school career by attending Garfield Elementary. After completing grade school, April next enrolled at Franklin Middle School for grades 6, 7, and 8. Ready for high school, April entered Washington to become a loyal warrior. She has been a student at the Transition Center for the past 3 years. Every few years, the Transition Center gets a student who becomes the ambassador for our program, someone who is a hard worker, has great social skills, and is loved by the employers. April is an ambassador for the program. During her tenure here, she has worked at nearly every one of our cruise sites. At the Clarion Hotel, April cleaned rooms after guest stays. The room was always spotless when she finished. Mom only wishes she would keep her own room that clean. Gordman's department store gets their shipment of goods in every Tuesday and Thursday. At Gordman's, April's duties include unpacking the merchandise and tagging them for prices. Good thing she doesn't have a credit card. If she did, it would be maxed out. Benchmark Corporation needed a person to assist with recycling duties. April was a favorite of the employees there. She was always polite and had a smile to share. After experiencing several supervised cruise sites, the staff felt it was time for her to try working independently in the community. Zinn's restaurant was right across the street, far enough away for her to test her independence, yet close enough for staff to keep a watchful eye. Well, the staff's instincts were correct. April did a wonderful job polishing silverware. In fact, Chris, the manager, said she was the best person that we have ever sent to them. Ready for the next challenge, it was decided to have April complete a Goodwill work evaluation to further enhance her work skills and to see if she was truly ready to enter the workforce. One of the goals for her was to be able to ride the city bus independently. This was a big step. She passed with flying colors. April has always enjoyed Special Olympics, but not always being the center of attention. During her time here, she has participated in bowling and track and field. She's earned several medals and ribbons over the years. April loves to go shopping in her free time. If you can't find her on the weekends, check the mall. She also loves the public library. We actually had to limit her to checking out 4 items per visit. Otherwise, there wouldn't be anything left for the other patrons. After graduation, April will go to work at Goodwill Industries part-time and attend the ARC Dayhab program. April and her parents have toured several area group homes, and at some point, April will move into one of them. April, it's always been a pleasure to serve you. Come back and visit us. Good luck at Goodwill. You're going to do a great job. Congratulations, April. Our next graduate is Andrea Luke. Andrea started her school career in Cedar Rapids by attending Wright Elementary. After completing her primary grades, she enrolled at Harding Middle School. Having survived her middle school years, it was time to move on to high school, where she attended Kennedy and became another loyal Cougar. Andrea has been a student here at the Transition Center for the past 3 years. Like most students that have been at the Transition Center for 3 years, Andrea has been able to experience nearly all of our supervised work crew sites. At Quiznos Restaurant, Andrea was in charge of bussing tables, washing dishes, and restocking paper supplies. At Grantwood AEA, our students package science kits that are sent to teachers throughout our district. This job requires strong attention to detail and accuracy. Andrea was the person for the job. The Clarion Hotel is always looking for good cleaners. April and Andrea were the perfect team. Jerry, their supervisor, called them the Merry Maids. Occasionally, the Transition Center would have a student absent. As a result, staff would ask a student to fill in at a work site. More often than not, staff would ask Andrea to fill in. She always obliged. Andrea even worked independent in the community for a while. At Zinn's Restaurants, she also polished the silverware. A Goodwill work evaluation seemed like the next logical step for Andrea. The work evaluation is designed to assess a student's ability to work competitively in the community. So for 12 weeks last spring, Andrea participated in the work evaluation program at Goodwill. Andrea, too, has enjoyed Special Olympics. During her time at the Transition Center, she has participated in bowling and track and field. Anyone who knows Andrea is aware that she loves anime characters. She meets regularly with other anime enthusiasts at the public library. Andrea even takes a road trip every summer to the National Anime Convention. Andrea also enjoys visiting local libraries in her free time. She loves checking out movies and books. After graduation, Andrea will remain a client of the REM Host Home Program. Her host parents, Bob and Diane, are great people. Andrea plans to attend the Rescue Dayhab program. Andrea, it's been fun having you here. The 3 years have gone by so fast. Good luck in the future. We will miss you. Congratulations. Our next graduate is Austin Ort. Austin started his schooling by attending Hoover Elementary in Cedar Rapids. From there, Austin entered Taft Middle School. Ready for high school, he enrolled at Jefferson to become a loyal Jayhawk. Austin has been a student at the Transition Center for the last 3 years. When a student is fortunate enough to spend 3 years at the Transition Center, most of them get to experience nearly all of those supervised work crew sites, such is the case for Austin. If there is one thing you can say about Austin, it's that he has great work skills and is very good at a variety of things. Duties at Grantwood AEA and the Clearinghouse require someone who has good counting skills. Austin is the man for the job. At our district offices, our students would shred documents. That's when we were out at Kingston Village in those FEMA trailers that Mrs. Lehman talked about. And I know that the staff there loved seeing our kids, and they did a variety of jobs for us. At United Fire Insurance, he was assigned the task of purging files. Austin did such a great job there that we no longer go there because he's done all the work. The Department of Human Services is always looking for volunteers to assemble mailing or stamp envelopes. You won't find a person with more attention to detail than Austin. Of all things that Austin does well, his strongest skill is cleaning. At the Clarion Hotel, Austin would prepare a room for the next visitor. I think it is safe to say that no student in the history of the Transition Center has ever done a better job of cleaning a room than Austin. Now, we can't say what his room looks like at home, but the rooms that he cleans at the Clarion are spotless. D Electronics is a company that sells electronic components for semi-trailers. Austin was in charge of packaging these parts for shipment. As we have come to expect, he did a fantastic job. Austin has always loved bowling. In fact, he has his own personal bowling ball and shoes. Naturally, he participates in Special Olympics bowling. Austin has always participated in track and field with the Transition Center. He's very proud of his ribbons and medals. When Austin has some free time, he's often on his phone looking at the latest apps. He also enjoys using the computer and hanging out with his friends. After graduation, Austin will attend the ARC Dayhab program while waiting for a position to open up at Goodwill. Austin, it's been a great 3 years. No one in this graduating class has made more progress. When you came to us 3 years ago, you weren't very motivated and didn't have the skills that you needed to be successful. Now look at you. We are all so proud of you. Good luck, Austin. We're really going to miss you. Congratulations, Austin. Micah Meering. Micah began his schooling at Grant Elementary here in Cedar Rapids. From there, he attended Van Buren to complete his primary grades. Ready for middle school, Micah enrolled at Roosevelt and became a Rough Rider. Next stop for Micah was Kennedy. Micah was a student at the Transition Center for 1.5 years. During Micah's time at the Transition Center, he was able to experience a variety of our community-based work sites. At the Salvation Army, the students assist with cleanup after meals are served to the elderly and needy. Micah was always very kind and caring to these folks. He quickly established a bond with many of them. At the Clarion Hotel, Micah was in charge of cleaning rooms. Although he never really liked cleaning bathrooms, he always did them without hesitation. Micah was doing so well with the crew work that it was decided to have Micah participate in a Goodwill evaluation. The purpose of the evaluation was to assess work skills and determine if he was ready for competitive employment. At the completion of the assessment, the team sits down to discuss the results. Not to our surprise, Micah did an outstanding job. The staff at Goodwill raved about what a pleasant person Micah was. Micah loved being with his peers, so when his friends decided to participate in Special Olympics, he did as well. He loved bowling and track and field. For Micah, it was never about winning. It was about having fun. Micah was always quite the ladies' man. The girls loved him because he was so polite and respectful. Micah was very close to his brother as well. It was evident by the way he spoke about him. Micah passed away in December from a sudden illness. The Transition Center has moved on. but there has been a sense of emptiness at the transition center since that day. Not all of us understand why these things happen. Many of us were left with a lot of questions. Wilma, you raised a wonderful young man. He was a role model for the program, and it was a pleasure to serve him for the short time we did. The future was very bright for him. He always told us, someday I'm going to move into a group home. He always thought the perks would be great. I bet the perks are pretty good where he is now. We'd like to recognize Micah and his mother, Wilma. Okay, graduates, stand up and be recognized. While our graduates are processing out, would you just wait a few moments, and then we're going to serve some refreshments in the back, and we'd like you to stay and join us. Thank you.